That coffee is great. This is Dick Cerri with Music Americana on 94.7 W Light for a Sunday night. And just before we talk with Cy Conn, let's play a Cy Conn song. This is one he wrote a couple of years ago, and one of the first people to record the song was Ginny Clemons from Chicago. And she, I think they'll check with Cy to find out what the title, final title was, but Ginny called it, "It's Not Just What You're Born With." I think the other title was, you know, "It's Not What You Do With What You Have, But What..." It's not what you have, but it's what you do with what you got. Here's the song.
You must know someone like him. He was tall and strong and lean. Body like a greyhound. Mind so sharp and keen. But his heart just like a laurel. Grew twisted on itself. Till almost everything he did brought pain. Someone else. It's not just what you're born with, it's what you choose to bear. It's not how much you share is, but how much you share. It's not the fights you dream of, but those you've really fought. It's not just what you're given, but what you do with what you got. What's the use of two good legs if you only run away? What's the good of a golden voice if you've nothing good to say? What good are strength and muscle if you only push and shove? What's the use of two good ears if you can't hear those you love? It's not just what you're born with, it's what you choose to bear. It's not how much you share is, but how much you can share. Fight you dream of, but those you've really fought. It's not just what you're given, but what you do with what you got. Between those who use their neighbors, those who use a cane. Between those in constant power and those in constant pain. Between those who run to evil and those who cannot run. Tell me which ones are such the sun. It's not just what you're born with, it's what you choose to bear. It's not how much you share is, but how much you can share. It's not the fights you dream of, but those you really want. It's not just what you're given, but what you do.
It's not just what you do with what you... But it's one of those titles that I guess you can say... I don't know. Cy Conn, you're the writer. What title did you give that song?
Well, Dick, I gave it What You Do With What You Got, but it was for lack of a better title.
All right. Ginny Clemons is the person who sang It's Not Just What You're Born With is the title she gave to it.
Well, I guess it's as good a title as the other one. They're both tough titles to remember.
Well, it's a great song.
Thanks, Dick.
Do you remember when you wrote this?
I wrote that in 1984, and I remember the circumstances. It was for a special issue of Sing Out magazine that was being put together for the International Year of Disabled Persons. And Gene Stewart, who was the special editor for that particular issue of Sing Out, called up and asked if I would write a song for the occasion. And I said I'd be glad to write the song as long as I had somebody who was an expert on the issue who would agree to review it, and she said she was and would. So I put it together based on her sense of what people who were of different abilities would want in a song for themselves. And since she's in that situation as a leader in that movement, she was well credentialed to do the review on it.
That's a great song. I think a lot of other people heard that and picked up on it. Also, as they do with a lot of your song, Aragon Mill, I think, has become a classic now. How does it feel to sit back there and watch all your songs become classics?
Well, it's real nice. It's real nice. One of the nicest things, Dick, was about 2 years ago, one of my children was in Ireland, and they were passing a record store, and Aragon Mill was coming out of a loudspeaker. And so they went inside and said, "Gee, that's an interesting song. Where does it come from?" They said, "Oh, that's a traditional Irish song from the north."
It's amazing.
I think that's... It makes me feel wonderful, to be quite honest. It's real nice.
Well, yes, if someone thinks that your music is
a song that's been around for generations, then it speaks well of your writing. Cy Conn, are you down in Charlotte?
I'm sitting in my office here in Charlotte, North Carolina.
Isn't that nice, the marvels of electronics this day and age? Did you just come back from some trip somewhere?
Yeah, I was in, to tell you the truth, I was on vacation with my wife. It was wonderful.
I knew you were out of town. What did you do on your vacation?
I listened to music. I sat. I read. We talked. We ate. We walked. We were lazy.
Do you get a chance to be lazy very often, Cy?
Not as much as I'd like. Between family with three children and the songwriting and the singing and the organizing work with grassroots leadership, it's a full life. There's not a whole lot of laziness in it. On the other hand, there's a lot of entertainment, and there's a lot of good feeling that comes from the people that I work with, and I'm well satisfied with the life that I lead. I feel real grateful for what I've had.
Well, according to our calendar here, you're on your way to Washington, a date coming up.
I'm going to be at the Birchmere on, I guess, you probably have the date there. I don't have the date in my head.
It's a Saturday.
Okay,
let me get the big cue sheet out here. Hold it up a little higher there.
There it is. It's Saturday, the 22nd of April.
You got it.
Yeah.
Cy Conn solo performance. Does that mean you're going to be all alone?
It means I'm going to be all alone. It's the easiest way to rehearse.
That's true. Also easy to travel that way.
Yeah, you travel light. Now, I miss the companionship of other folks to play with, but it's harder when there's a day job and people that I would choose to play with are fairly spread out. It's hard to get the time to put something together that's really smooth, and I think audiences deserve something that's well-polished. And if there's not time to rehearse, then you shouldn't try to perform in an unrehearsed style.
You also have a new album out. Matter of fact, we just got a new CD.
Good.
By Cy Conn.
You're seeing this before I am.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Oh.
How's it look?
Looks very good.
Great.
You've got... let's see, design here by Jennifer Berman. Now, we don't give designers too much credit on radio. Person who sits down and designs an album cover very seldom gets any recognition whatsoever.
Well, she deserves it. She's done several of my album covers. I think does a wonderful job.
Well, we're going to give you a little treat here, Cy. If this is the first time you're hearing about it, we're going to play something from it so that you get a chance to hear what they've done with things.
Oh, listen, I'm glad I've got my hi-fi stereo telephone on.
freedom. We are reaching, we are reaching, we are reaching out for freedom. Every door opens a door, every door opens a door, every door opens a door to the future. Every door opens a door.
Rocking and rolling around here, Si, everybody dancing. Hey, what do you got on this record? You got saxophone, lots of instruments. Sounds
folk,
good.
Folk music you can dance to.
We had Noel Paul Stuckey on last week. He called it, I want to say high-tech, but it wasn't his. High-tech folk, you know, some of these new terms that are being used to describe some of the new music being made by people who, in the past, were primarily guitar and bass, and that's it. Where was it done?
When was it done?
Where?
Oh, was it right here in town, Mike Rivers Gypsy Studios over in Alexandria.
Well, when you say right here in town, SciCon, you're in Charlotte, North Carolina, so I naturally think you're saying in Charlotte, but you're talking about right here in Washington.
I'm taking the national perspective.
Dave. I got it. So you did it right here in town?
Right there in town.
Well,
yeah, and part of it was done at Wolf Trap as well. I used the piano there for some of the cuts with Howard Levy and used Mike Rivers' mobile studio to go out and do that. At about 3 in the morning, by the way. Kept falling asleep between takes.
Well, with a song like that, I could see where you could get rejuvenated and continue on very nicely. But it sounds great. You got Paul Reisler on here that sort of got things together?
Well, Paul is the producer, and I think he brings so much musical knowledge. I'm really a songwriter. I'm not an instrumentalist, I'm not an arranger, and it's wonderful to have somebody, both Paul and the other musicians on it, who can, you know, can really put flesh on the bones. You know, and having vocalists like, you say, Barnwell and Kathy Fink and Mary Chapin Carpenter, and then all the instrumentalists, people like Howard Levy and Pete Kennedy, another, you know, great Washington musician on it. It really makes a difference. Makes a whole lot of difference.
Well, I got that kind of talent, sure does. All right, Mr. SciCon, we look forward to your coming to Washington, your annual trip up. When was the last time you were here?
Oh, to perform? I guess it's been a good year and a half ago.
I was going to say, at least.
It's been a while.
At least a year.
Yes, I'm looking forward to seeing friends.
All right, give us the date once again.
The date is Saturday, April the 22nd. That's, I guess, the weekend after next at the Birchmere. And I assume folks can look up the phone number in the phone book.
Well, we can give all that information. And as the title of your album says, Mr. SciCon,
I'll be there.
When the times are darkest, I'll be there. When the way is hardest, I'll be there. When the need is strongest, I'll be there. When the road is longest, I'll be there. I'll be there. I'll be there. I'll be there. Oh, I'll be there. Be there for my sister. I'll be there. Be there for my brother. I'll be there. Be there for my lover. I'll be there. Be there for each other. I'll be there. When the world is dying, I'll be there.
Well, I guess you got the word. Yes, you'll be there. I'll be there. That's the title song of the new PsyCon. CD and disc and tape and PsyCon will be at the Birchmere on Saturday, April the 28th, in a solo performance.
Just west of the city is the best of country life. That old neighborhood feeling, a town that's doing bright. Raising a family, working and playing. A new town, a new home, together the right way.
Finally brought to Prince William County what homebuyers have wanted all along. A new town with all the trimmings. The lakes, parks, shops and restaurants, swim and tennis club, along with affordable new homes from Virginia's most popular quality builders. Is it any wonder they're selling so fast?
Moving in the right direction. Move up to Bull Run.
Affordable new homes in a new town. Look for Bull Run in Saturday's Post.
Long Fence presents House Hunting in the Future.
It's a lovely house.
It's really a lovely house.
It's been in the family for years. My grandfather built it way back in 85.
18?
No, 1985.
Of course, there's just some things that need to go.
Go?
The microwave in the kitchen.
Totally outdated.
The telephones.
Ridiculous. So old-fashioned.
And the fence.
Excuse me, but that's a long fence.
It's over 60 years old.
But it's the Westwood model, built to last a long time.
It still looks great, dear.
Let me take out my materials analyzer. It hasn't turned gray with age. That's some fence.
It's a long fence.
Called the Westwood, huh?
Built to last a long time. My grandfather had great foresight.
Okay, we'll take it.
The house?
The fence. It'll last longer.
Long fence, just a phone call away.
The Westwood, now on sale at Long Fence. Look in the white pages for the Long Fence nearest you.
This is Dick Cerri with Music Americana on 94.7 WLite. It's Sunday, April the 9th. Every now and then we get a little note saying, would you kindly give the date every now, because we make a tape of your show and send it over to Saudi Arabia. And sometimes it gets back, and people are listening to it 6 months from now are not sure. So anyway, we'll throw that in. All right. It's Ladies' Night on Music Americana, the women of folk music. Joan Baez, Judy Collins, Joni Mitchell, Christine Lavin, Kathy Fink, Marcy Marxer, Mary Black, Kate Wolf, Ann Hills, Mattie Pryor, June Tabor, Chenille Sisters, Judy Small, Cindy Mankson, Carla Siaki, Ann Dotson, Mimi Farinian, Jane Gilman, Nancy Griffith, Cheryl Wheeler, Sean Coven, on and on and on. If there is a particular song you'd like to hear by one of our ladies, you can give us a call at 984-6000, area code 301. We are still trying to get the Mall song by Patty Larkin set up because it's a very funny song that shows off her talent. Speaking of Patty Larkin, Patty's from Boston, up in the New England area. Here's another lady from that neck of the woods.
Thank you. welcome, Daddy. Oh, sail away, ladies, sail away. Sail away, ladies, sail away. Sail away, ladies, sail away. Sail away, ladies, sail away.
Take off the old man's beard and I'll kiss the good one.
The yuppie of Denver is what Carla Siaki calls that. And before Carla, we heard the Silly Sisters, two great talents from Ireland, Manny Pryor and June Tabor, and the Barring of the Daw, and Ann Dotson from Maine, and Sail Away Ladies. It's Ladies' Night on Music Americana on 94.7. We're going to see if we can get our crew, our singing crew in here, our Music Americana staff, has been rehearsing. We're going to do something special here. We're going to do it on the air. So we're going to call them all together. As they're gathering all their forces up, we remind you that the annual Black Tie Affair Super Bowl 89 will be held on Saturday, April the 22nd. To benefit the Easter Seal Society, it'll be at the Washington Convention Center. And if you'd like more information on this, you can call 429-1777. 429-1777.
Hello.
Ladies and gentlemen, Becky, get up here a little bit. Wait, you're always back to the door there.
Music
Becky Flanagan is...
Cleo, not
yeah.
Cleo, okay.
And Sean McGee has got his Cool Joe T-shirt on there.
That's Joe, yeah.
Cool Joe, that's... who is that? That's
Cujo,
Peanuts.
That was a
Peanuts.
Snoopy.
Snoopy of Peanuts, that's it. And, of course, Doris here. Every month, usually every month, I say that the month we don't will not be at the Birchmere.
We are. You're right.
What we're about to do here is to honor an individual who's associated with the Birchmere who is celebrating a birthday this very day.
That's right.
This is the day. Mm-hmm. It's a birthday that those of us who have reached it don't want to talk about.
We're not. Are we not going to say
that? We're not going to say that. The only thing we could say is that he is now eligible for AA... R.P.
Okay.
Not AA, but
yeah,
AARP.
Right. AARP,
that organization that talks to people, we won't say what the age,
yeah.
Yes. But anyway, because we've known this gentleman for such a long time, and since he's always been very cooperative.
Helpful.
He's responsible for a lot of shallow, unmarked graves in the parking lot.
That's it. I knew I was looking for something here. We wanted to wish Pudge... Yeah. He's the guy that you see when you walk in the door and you say, my God, am I supposed to be here? You know, he looks at you with that gentle smile of his, like he's going to pound your head in the floor.
He decides later if you're supposed to be there.
Yes. But he's the one that enforces the law. There's no talking while the performer is on stage. Pudge is having a birthday. So we're all going to get together here now, and I don't know who's leader.
Doris. Can
all right, Doris. All right.
Happy birthday.
No, it's the wrong one.
Happy birthday.
I'm trying.
I'm trying.
What's this?
No.
What's your note right there?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Pudge. Happy birthday to you.
Oh. All right. Oh, that's super.
Go.
Hey.
Yeah.
Not many people get a live happy birthday on the radio.
Where's our check?
Yes. Well, maybe we'll get better service this time, huh?
Yeah.
When you see Pudge this week, if you go over to the Birch Beer, he's the guy with the big beard. Say, happy birthday, Pudge. We know how old you are. You've reached that age. You're up among the scholars. You won your $50. Oh, my God. That goes back many years ago. Anyway, happy birthday, Pudge. We love you. Music Americana on 94.7. It's Ladies Night, and we'll continue with our Women of Folk Music in a moment.
At the Jewel Boutique, we're now conducting a diamond-studded solid gold going-out-of-business sale every business day till the final curtain May 31st. After nearly 30 years in the show business, this is our farewell performance. We've shown the finest jewelry anywhere, and we've sold sound investments without a lot of song and dance. Like when Mr. Gilberstein popped the big question, our classic rocks were a big hit. And when Mr. Jones forgot his wife's birthday and had to face the music, a necklace from our string section restored harmony. The Jewel Boutique has always offered beautiful pieces, and during our final performance, we're offering unheard-of savings on them all. All our finely tuned instruments like Rolex and Cartier watches, our gold hits, earrings, bracelets, rings, and pearls, even prices on stones will be music to your ears. So make a concerted effort to attend the Jewel Boutique's farewell performance sale, where everything is going for a song.
Visit their going out of business sale and save up to 40%. Weekdays 10 to 8, Sunday 12 to 5. All sales final.
Music Americana on 94.7 is sponsored in part by the Gables on Tuckerman.
The mystery of the townhome condominium. Our story opens in Montgomery County at the Gables on Tuckerman Lane.
Colonel Ketchup, everyone is dying to know. What is a townhome condominium?
Where can we find a clue, Professor Peach?
I suggest in the kitchen with the microwave.
No, Miss Fuchsia, in the living room with the fireplace.
I suggest the bathroom with a marble vanity, Mrs. Black.
The den, the dining room, egad, we need more clues.
Could it be in the Gables private clubhouse?
No, the clue is right in his home.
Has anyone looked upstairs?
Oh, impossible. Who ever heard of a condominium with an...
We solved the mystery. Egad, what value. The Gables adds a new level to luxury living. That's what makes it a townhome condominium.
Solve the mystery yourself. Visit the Gables on Tuckerman Lane today. To miss it would be a crime.
The Gables on Tuckerman. One bedroom from the 130s, twos from the 170s. Call 762-6322 or see the ad in the Post Real Estate section. Now get $7,500 towards closing.
Hi, this is Christine Lavin. You're listening to Music Americana with Dick Cerri.
Everyone I know is getting married next summer. Living together just isn't enough, I guess. Blushing 30-year-old brides register their china pattern and go shopping for that long white dress. Maybe she's becoming aware of her own mortality. The thought of having children doesn't seem so wrong. Maybe he's grown tired of looking for that perfect woman when the perfect woman's been there all along. I've seen them walking down the aisle, the groom nervous, the bride all smiles, but think they know each other well, but looking in their eyes, no one could tell. They're trying hard to cover up those they don't feel. And I've stood there with the single women when the bride throws the bouquet. Danced with the best man and all the relatives. The music sounds so tinny as I glide across the room. Oh, it feels strange to dance at weddings of those who swore they'd never marry. Buzz off now on their honeymoon. Everyone I know is getting married next summer. Living together is no longer enough, I guess. Blushing 35-year-old brides register their silver and go shopping for that long white dress. dance with the girl who gives you the eye and lets you hold it tight. You can smile, every smile for the one who held your hand neath the pale moonlight. But don't forget who's taking you home and in his arms you're gonna be.
You're listening to the Women of Folk Music on Music Americana on 94.7 WLite, WLTT, Bethesda, Washington.
I have been wondering what I'm gonna do. While you are sleeping, am I sleeping too? Well, I'm just sitting here loving you. If you've been wondering just what I would do.
exactly what we're doing, sitting back here, loving what you're doing. That's Mary Black and John Sebastian's Loving You, and before that, Mary McCaslin, Save the Last Dance for Me. Who was it that says rock and roll becomes folk music once it goes around a couple of times? Yeah. Save the Last Dance for Me, and before that, Christine Lavin with Summer Weddings. That do remind me, next Saturday, I finally take the hand, or the... How do we do this? Never done it in the Cerri family, so it's very difficult. We've always eloped. So my father eloped, my brother eloped, I eloped. My daughter is going through with the big production number. Yes, Debbie Ann Cerri is getting married next Saturday to Brian Sullivan, a very nice young man, even though he's involved in radio. Hey, I tried. You know how parents say, where did I go wrong? Well, hey, Brian seems to be level-headed,